What's going on, guys? I'm
Smosa! That was my next pick.
And since I started playing softball with the crew over at Dodger Films, I naturally started to get more interested in baseball.
Oh! Dude, it hit that dude in his hand.
More specifically, how different pitches affect the trajectory of a baseball. As it turns out, a lot of people know that the spin of the ball affects the trajectory, but not a lot of people know why.
So I recruited my buddy Fireball here. Can you help me try to understand, how does the ball curve?
Well, it mainly has to do with the finger position, how you throw the ball, and usually how it's the fingers and how you deliver it. So like the curve ball, you kind of go over the top like this, and it like comes out of your hand.
The way a baseball pitcher held the ball was different for each throw. They didn't simply hold the ball firmly in their hand. There was a philosophy to each throw. So let's break down the physics of a baseball and really try to understand its design and characteristics. There are three axes a ball can spin on, the X, Y, and Z. A top spin is when the ball rolls forward on the X axis. A backspin is when the ball rolls backwards on the X axis. These two spins are important because they go in the direction and against the direction the ball is moving. Professional baseballs are a lot smoother than the ones you'll find on your local Little League field. The seams are more flush with the surface as to not give the professional pitchers any advantage. As it would turn out, a rough ball has more drag. Drag is the force on an object as it travels through the air that slows it down. It's essentially air resistance. As air collides with a rough ball, including the seams, it catches on all the bumps and imperfections, slowing it down. This is where the spin of the ball comes into play. One side of the ball is spinning in the direction the air is moving, and the other is spinning against it. This causes the air around the ball to have different velocities. Bernoulli's equation simply shows that a fluid, in this case air, that has a slower velocity also has a higher pressure, and a fluid with a higher velocity has a lower pressure. This causes the ball to have a pressure differential between the top and bottom. It's pretty clear how every other throw can be created now. It's just a variation of forward and backward spins combined with spins in the Y and Z direction. Something that's kind of cool about this is you could throw a ball farther if you know how to get a spin on the ball right. Imagine you had a pitching machine that you can control the speed on. No matter how fast the ball is traveling parallel to the ground, every pitch from the machine will hit the ground in the same amount of time, assuming the ball had no spin. That's because the velocity in the Y direction for a perfect throw is zero, and the gravity acting on every pitch is the same. But backspin helps fight the force of gravity because there is a slight pressure differential on the ball, resulting in a slight force on the ball upwards. That backspin is just enough to help keep the ball flying straighter for longer distances than just a regular throw. But speaking of a regular old throw, we know what happens when a ball is spinning in the air, but what about a pitch that has little to no spin? That is called a knuckleball. And it's a devastating pitch that seasoned veterans believe to be such a cheap trick that they don't even promote it to newer pitchers in some instances. So what's going on? Why is a knuckleball so hard to hit? You would assume that a ball with no spin would fly pretty straight, right? Kind of. What you're seeing is chaotic fluid dynamics in play. And yes, air is a fluid. Basically, all the abrasions, cuts, and stitches on the ball do impart some resistance in a slight uneven fashion. It's so subtle that when the ball does slightly change trajectory, air resistance can change subtly, causing it to veer in another trajectory. When all of these subtle chaotic pressures come in together, you wind up with a ball that wiggles unpredictably in the air, causing even the best batters to swing aimlessly. But anyways, that was just a quick look at the physics of a baseball pitch. If you have any suggestions for future videos, be sure to leave them in the comments down below, and check out Fireball Jimmy's channel for more baseball videos, as well as Dodger Films. The link to their channels are down in the description. Anyways guys, this has just been a quick look at baseball. This has been Mike for SpacePak. Thanks for watching.
Bat?
No. Like, I mean, when they pitch the ball, how do they get like a curve ball or a knuckle ball? Like, how does that work?
Physics. It's all physics. You know, you have to be a.
Well, I know the physics, okay. but how? I mean, how does?
Simple.
Try to explain it as simple as you can. Is it how they hold it or what?
It's where you hold the ball. How much snap you put into a ball. Or how much finesse you put into it.
So is there a different type of throw? Like, do you have to move your arm differently for different throws, for different pitches?
Exactly. You don't want to do that because you'll just tip off the batter of what you're throwing every time.
Okay.
So you want to keep the same arm angle, same release and everything. Only thing is, it'll be different grips, different snaps, different finesse on it.
Does that, like, change the spin?
of the ball?
Definitely, definitely. When you snap it on a curveball, you snap it. Change up, you go the opposite way. Knuckleball, you finesse it, you let the ball go off your hand. It's crazy. Baseball's a lovely game. It's a chess game, I'll tell you that.